Hello students, in this video I am going to talk about how to plan for CA final, and this video is specifically for those students who have just appeared CA inter or are waiting for the results of CA inter. In CA final we often say if you are failing to plan, you are surely planning to fail. It's all the game of planning and balancing. Until CA inter, friends, what do you actually see is you are studying with tuitions and your college. But in CA final, the journey shifts very differently to a next level, whereby you have to be mentally prepared for the adventures to come. The adventures are adventures only if you have no idea of what is going to come in my journey. But if you know your milestones well, this adventure can become a very smooth and exciting trip. There's a difference between trip and adventure. So trip is a more planned thing whereby you achieve your goals surely. And adventure is a risky thing whereby you may or may not achieve what you're looking for. So, dear friends, CA, we are not doing for adventure. We are doing it for some reason. And you are just now a level away when you are in CA final. In this video, I'm going to share with you some critical aspects about these following points. That is your articleship training, mode of tuition in this new reality post-pandemic, number of subjects, time required, basically the standard time that you should devote to each subject while taking tuitions, sequence of tuitions, additional courses if you want, what it can be, any other degree if you are willing to join, then what it can be, and how to achieve sure shot success. Guys, I am CA Satish Jalan. I teach SCMP subject and SFM subject in CA final, as well as cost and financial management in CA inter. In our institute, we also teach CMA inter subjects. We have very good, remarkable, dedicated faculties for teaching subjects of CMA inter. We recently started with our class 11 and 12 commerce also, which is being accepted by our students very well. We have also tied up with best of the teachers of the country to provide you classes of all other subjects under one roof, details of which are available on our SJC website. Friends, if you really find the content of this video attracting, worth listening, do share the word with your friends who are possibly not watching this video. And also, I will request that you watch this video along with your parents so that they also understand what actually is expected in CA final. First of all, friends, it's, as you can see, articleship training. This is one of the very interesting part in your CA final syllabus. Yeah, it's a part of syllabus. In articleship, what you do is basically learn the things practically, the subjects that you have done theoretically in intermediate, like taxation, like company's law, then audit, then of course financial accounting. You get to do those work practically now, so it's very exciting when you go. But at the same time, we have seen that students who have not planned their studies well or balanced their studies well with their articleship, they have lost a lot of confidence with their office or with their study or with both. We don't wish that you become a victim or a survivor. We wish that you should be able to sail smoothly in this journey. So this articleship journey is usually very, very hectic. So be mentally prepared. Try to find out your articleship firm as soon as possible, because as per the guidelines of institute, after passing CA Inter, only you can do the articleship. And as per the latest rules, you can start your articleship even after passing group 1, even after passing any group rather, either group 1 or group 2. So you can start your articleship after passing any group. Prefer that you are starting it only after both the groups. That is preferred. See, I'm going to tell you only the most ideal scenarios, because we have seen that the students who join articleship just after passing one group and keeping the other group of intermediate due, they face lot of challenge in completing the second group, because office doesn't give you enough time to study at home. That's a brutal fact that we all need to accept, and that is only the expectation from the articleship, all right, that you need to balance your self-study or tuitions along with articleship. So they will only provide you limited time. I will not say they don't provide you time. They will only provide you limited time for all those stuffs, and your majority time of the day will be consumed in the office. So we have seen that students who appear for group 2 during articleship, they suffer a lot of challenges. They suffer usually a lot of challenges while completing group 2. So it's my suggestion that you join articleship only if you have passed both the groups. So that gives you more confidence towards your articleship as well as towards your final study. Alright. As per ICA guidelines, you have to serve 2.5 years of articleship in order to appear for your final exam. So normally, say I'll take one example. If say result is coming in the month of February, for example, this is the result out date, February, which is the intermediate result date. So from there, 2.5 years you need to count, and that would be the term of your CA final first attempt. All right. And this period of 2.5 years will be utilized how? We generally say that you should leave this 6 months before your final exam in hand, that you will not be doing any tuition during this period. And this 6 months should be only consumed for self-study and revision. So remaining is how much time now? 2 years. The day you start your articleship, preferred that day only you must start your preparation for CA final subjects as well. See, most important, what is required is your balancing of study time with articleship time, balancing of work plus study. Normally in corporate world we say work life and personal life, but in case of students like you, CA students, dear my students, I am always with you, but forget personal life for time to come, until at least you become a CA. So it's just your two lives now, work life and study life. All right. So if you plan well about your study life, then you are able to do both work and study in a balanced way. So in this session, I'm just going to guide you with how should you plan your study life along with the work. See, work is, once you start with any firm, you have to continue. I never advise you to jump over different firms. There may be some questions like whether we should join big firm or small firm. See, wherever you get opportunity, you should join. Big firms are also very good. Small firms are also very good. There is an opportunity to learn. And if for any specific queries that you have to consult separately, I am just now advising in general terms. Next, number two, second point is how would be the mode of tuition in the coming reality post pandemic. So normally in finals, pre-pandemic, let me talk about pre-pandemic. Pre-pandemic also, the students in final were always preferring to do classes at home because that gives them a lot of convenience and comfort when they are doing articleship. You never know where today your firm would be asking you to go. Maybe IT department's office, or maybe some client office which is very far from your office or your home, or maybe to some outstation audit. It may happen, right? So if all those are happening, you tend to miss face-to-face classes, and then there is unnecessary running for your backup classes. So that creates a lot of stress. So students were preferring already, like I will say more than 80% students, I'm very conservative here, 80%, I'll say more than 90% students have already started preferring classes at home, which they were doing in Google Drive or Pen Drive mode. Google Drive is basically you have to download from Google Drive link, and Pen Drive is basically that you don't need to download, everything will come in the Pen Drive, so just plug and play. Post-pandemic, since face-to-face classes are a bit uncertain now, so every tuition almost has been started giving classes at home. It is one of the options. Some of the teachers have also started live classes at home, live at home mode, including us, of course, live classes at home. So that you may avail. For live classes, you need to have consistent internet connection throughout the classes. So if you are in a locality where you face issues in data supply, although we say that we are in 4G world of Jio, but still I understand that there is still not even distribution everywhere. So if you are in a position or locality where you are not able to get these data supply continuously, then prefer classes at home in GDPD mode, or live classes at home is basically live at a certain defined time whereby you're not going to center, but you're studying directly live from home. Live classes has its own advantages, as in it will bring discipline inside you, and GDPD has its own advantage that it is as convenient as yours. All right, in GDPD you can always adjust the speed of learning, but in live classes you'll have to go with the speed of the class going on. So that you, I think, until this stage of your career, you are understanding what will suit me. I'm just trying to give you an idea of what would be the options available now. So classes at home, live classes at home, in my opinion, face-to-face classes, even if the options are available, you must see the precautions of COVID. Even after the vaccine, see, every medical company is also saying that still that social distancing needs to be continued. It's not that even if you're vaccinated for the virus, you will be normal like pre-pandemic. That days are not going to come. So the social distancing has to be continued forever. In places of coaching classes, usually the classes are very congested. So it somehow invites risk. So we all teachers, mostly all the teachers in CA fraternity, are not conducting any face-to-face classes as of now. And we all are providing our best in Google Drive, Pen Drive classes. In Kolkata, you know, in 2016-17, we at SJC was the pioneer, the first to bring the Pen Drive classes. And when students started understanding the convenience of Pen Drive classes, now the time has totally changed. Now in final, nobody prefers face-to-face classes, although it has got its own benefits because you get good environment, you get friends, you are disciplined, you get to interact with sir, but somehow we have to adjust ourselves with the new reality. All right, so these are the mode of tuitions. Third point is number of subjects. So this is something basic that you must know. If you know from before, it is very, very nice. You are proactive. If not, then you should know that there are two groups as usual, like inter, and each group has got four subjects. So first in group one is financial reporting, that is accounts. Second is SFM, which is FM, advanced FM. Third here is law. Full name I'm not writing, I'm writing just the colloquial name. And fourth is your audit. In group two, next subject is your, or rather first subject is SCM or costing. SCM is nothing but costing. Sixth is an elective subject. Out of six options, you have to select any one out of six. Usually students tend to select the one which is easy to pass, but institute is also getting smart. They are seeing the number of enrollments getting skewed in one particular subject, and that term they set a difficult paper for that subject. Anyways, elective subject, any one out of six you can select. It's an open book exam, so that selection can be done little later. It's not necessary that you have to decide about it immediately once you pass CA Inter. Seventh is your direct tax, and eighth is your indirect tax. You have studied DT, IDT together in one paper in Inter. Now they get split up into full 100-100 mark paper. All right. So these are your eight subjects. And next, with these eight subjects, I would like to share with you the time required. That is a basic thing to understand. Okay, time required is, I'm going to tell you a rough estimate of the number of classes that are done in one subject. So for accounts, you will always see that you have approximately 90 classes. There can be some 10 extra or 5 less. Plus 10 minus 5 can always be there. For SFM, you will see that there are 70 classes. There can be 10 extra minus 5. I'm just telling you a tentative number of classes that we teachers provide you in different subjects. Next, third in law, you have approximately 50 classes. Fourth in audit, you have approximately 50 classes. Then fifth for costing, that is SCM, you have approximately 85. Then elective subject, if any you are taking tuitions, that can be approx 30. There can be, this is an approximate figure. I'm not telling you that this is the standard number of classes. No, this is the approximate figure which I found out from different teachers' classes. So that I am just summarizing and telling you so that you have some rough idea about the effort that you have to put. DT is approx 80 classes and IDT is approx 60 classes. I've also tried to keep in mind some amendments and all that might be required. Now, in some subjects, you will see that some teachers are teaching 30, some teachers are teaching 40. Like in law, some teachers are doing it in 30 classes also, via regular course, and some teachers are doing in 60 classes also. So that averaging you have to do basically. Just for brief understanding, 9, 7, 16, 21, 260, and here it is 8, 3, 11, 19, 255. So altogether, I consider that there are approximately 515 to 20, 5 to 20 classes approximately, and each classes are usually supposed to be of 2.5 to 3 hours each. In some cases, it can go beyond 3 hours, बट यूजुअली लेट अस टेक 3 आवर्स अ डे, 3 आवर्स ईच. सो ऑल टुगेदर यू आर स्टडिंग 1650 आवर्स रफली. ऑल राइट, 1650 आवर्स रफली. सो गाइज, दिस 90 क्लासेस, इफ यू डू वन क्लास अ डे, इफ यू डू वन क्लास अ डे, विच इज आई कंसिडर मोर अप्रोप्रिएट फॉर यू, बिकॉज सम स्टूडेंट्स हु आर इन थर्ड ईयर ऑफ कॉलेज, सम स्टूडेंट्स डू कॉलेज राइट, सो दे माइट बी इन थर्ड ईयर इफ दे हैव पास इंटरमीडिएट ऑल इन वन अटेम्प्ट फ्रॉम नॉर्मल फाउंडेशन रूट. सो यू हैव टू मैनेज अ कॉलेज, देन देयर इज आर्टिकलशिप. ओके, मेनी स्टूडेंट्स गेट सो मच एग्जॉस्टेड जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टू, दैट दे टेंड टू इग्नोर देयर मेन एजेंडा विच इज स्टडी. द थर्ड वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज योर ट्यूशन, विच इज योर स्टडी एकेडेमिक टाइम. ऑल राइट, सो इफ से इन मॉर्निंग, प्रिज्यूम दैट इन मॉर्निंग यू आर डूइंग कॉलेज, डे टाइम आर्टिकलशिप, सो इवनिंग इज फॉर ट्यूशन. इफ से इवनिंग इज कॉलेज, देन डे टाइम आर्टिकलशिप, एंड लास्टली इन मॉर्निंग यू हैव टू डू ट्यूशन. सो 3 थिंग्स इफ यू आर मैनेजिंग. सो यू कैन नॉट डू टू ट्यूशंस और टू क्लासेस इन अ डे. फॉर ट्यूशन दैट्स हाउ आई एम एडवाइजिंग, जस्ट वन क्लास पर डे, वन क्लास पर डे. सो इफ वी आर डूइंग सर वन क्लास पर डे, इट माइट हैपन दैट वी आर अनेबल टू स्टडी ऑन ऑल द 7 डेज ऑफ अ वीक. येस आई एक्सेप्ट दैट. इट हैपन्स बिकॉज समटाइम्स ऑफिस हैज सेंट यू आउटसाइड, बिकॉज समटाइम्स ऑफिस हैज कॉल्ड यू फॉर समथिंग. इट हैपन्स बिकॉज ऑफ सम टाइम ऑफ योर कॉलेज एग्जाम एंड बिकॉज ऑफ सम अदर हेल्थ इशूज, पर्सनल कमिटमेंट्स एंड ऑल, इट कैन हैपन. बट एनी हाउ देर हैज़ टू बी सम अपर लिमिट ऑफ कम्प्लीटिंग एनी क्लास. लाइक 90 क्लासेज इफ यू आर अनेबल टू कम्प्लीट इन 90 डेज, देन समहाउ देर हैज़ टू बी सम अपर लिमिट दैट विद इन दैट पीरियड आई हैव टू कम्प्लीट इवन इफ आई एम नॉट स्टडिंग डेली. देर इज अगेन अ नीड ऑफ रिविजन ऑफ द क्लासेज ऑलवेज आफ्टर योर क्लास और बिफोर योर नेक्स्ट क्लास. सो इन टेक्निकल सेंस से इफ यू आर वेकिंग अप लेट, मे बी इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग कॉलेज, जस्ट आर्टिकलशिप एंड ट्यूशन. सो आर्टिकलशिप टिपिकली टेक्स 10 to 12 hours ऑफ योर डे एंड ट्यूशन टेक्स 3 to 4 hours ऑफ योर डे. सो दीज आर ऑल इफेक्टिव टाइम्स दैट यू ऑलरेडी डिवोट. देन यू हैव योर नॉर्मल स्लीपिंग बेदिंग टाइम. सो यू सी इट कंज्यूम्स योर 14-15 hours अप्रॉक्सीमेटली इन जस्ट दिस टू. सो यू हैव जस्ट 8 to 9 hours लेफ्ट फॉर एवरीथिंग एल्स. सो एंड इफ यू हैव कॉलेज फॉर 3-4 hours, देन सी हाउ मच स्ट्रिक्ट टाइम कॉन्स्ट्रेंट यू आर ऑलरेडी हैविंग. सो एनी हाउ आई फील दैट दिस अकाउंट्स क्लास यू शुड कम्प्लीट इन 4 months टाइम पीरियड, SFM in 3 months, law and audit together in 4 months, so I'll say 2 months each. Whenever you do class, 2 months each. See, this time allocation has been done by keeping in mind that you will be doing Google Drive, Pen Drive classes. The moment you join any live class, then you have to see whether it is coming in this time frame or not. Say if any tuition is extending beyond 4 months, then there can be overlap of 2 tuitions. You have to understand that and you have to accordingly manage both the tuitions. If say you have joined a accounts tuition and it is extending for 5 months, for instance, then 1 month overlapping has to be managed with SFM. So that would be really a tough time for you, because if you are also having college, then you generally have left with only 1 tuition in hand. But say if overlapping is there and with college, 1 tuition has to be skipped. Past we have seen that many students had to skip their 1 tuition because of overlapping timing of 2 tuitions. So for the skip tuition, they used to keep coming for backup, and that was another level of stress. I don't want you to see in any kind of stress for your study. So keep it streamlined like this, and you see this total 4, 3, 7 to 9 and 2, 11 months time period is required to cover everything over here. All right. 1 month buffer will be given to you, another level of buffer in order to give you some time for revision. I'll come to that. Next, for SCM, another I consider 4 months. Then for elective subject, I consider 1 month for 30 days, or say 2 months. Let me give you 2 months. Then for DT, 4 months. For IDT, 3 months. Not 3 months, sorry, 2 months. So why I gave you here 2 months? Actually, for 30 classes, you don't need 2 months, because I could not give you any buffer in IDT here. So I am considering a combined time of 4 months over here. So total is coming 12 months. So you see, you have to study for 23 months with less load if you have college in hand and if you want to take one tuition per day. If say after a year of time your college is over, then you get some surplus time in hand. So this surplus should be used for revision also, rather than just doing classes. If you do classes, two classes a day, then it's all messed up at the end, you know. You are only usually then taking the notes. We have seen struggling the students who are doing two classes and office. So for the purpose of office, you see, anyhow you have to work. But in case of classes, if it is Google Drive, Pen Drive, or even if it is face to face, we have seen that many students just tend to keep taking notes. And if any opportunity comes for any friend's birthday celebration or any kind of family get together, we are first to jump off to those by sacrificing our studies, because in office we don't have any control, we cannot say no. But for studies, it's all in our hands, so we tend to defer that, and ultimately, so what suffers is your career. So I don't want you to take pressure from day one. If you start early, you are always at lesser stress. Like this happens in our everyday exercise also. Say for instance, you wake up at 7, normal routine. And if you wake up at 7, what happens is you are pack to pack, continuous working for something. Maybe your daily schedule, then breakfast, then study time, then office. Now what happens is sometimes we tend to wake up a little late, maybe just 5-10 minutes extra sleep we always want to have, because at night we are always using our WhatsApp and Facebook for some time, and that gets stressed, so our sleep gets compromised. So we generally tend to sleep more 5-10 minutes, and that 5-10 minutes causes a lot of hurried up situation in our daily life, and we tend to forget things, and then we bang on things, and that is very usual. Now if say you just make your schedule in a way that if you have to wake up at 7 and you start waking up at 6:55 or 6:50, that extra 5-10 minutes will give you so much of luxury that you will be done with almost each and every activity, and still you will have some leisure. So you will be at a lot of peace if you do that. So same theory I am trying to apply with you, that if you started your classes early, then you don't need to do two tuitions together. You don't need to do. You just do one tuition together. Don't be at stress. Don't be on hurry of anything. And just keep sailing smoothly. Give your time to revision, because this 3 hours content when we talk in final is actually heavy content, like FR. This is all new IFRS, Ind AS. It's too heavy sometimes to absorb. Okay, sometimes it's interesting to listen, but in exam it's all about, you know, retention and practicing. So that needs time, and you cannot expect that a tuition that you have taken, you know, 2 years ago, and you will remember each and everything at 100% level after your completion of all the tuitions. So in order to be able to remember, what is required is, you know, after tuition you need to ensure that how will you remember it. You need to practice some questions so that your subsequent classes are also effective. It is very much needed. So all these you need to understand here. All right. So that's how I suggest that if, say, there is no college, the faculty is going on, then also never engage yourself into two class per day. Just engage yourself in one class per day. That is all enough. And do in your spare time some revision, which will give you grip over the subject. All right. So here, if you see, I have given you enough buffer also, like 90 classes has to be done in 4 months. Now 4 months is because in some teachers classes, it may go up to 100. In some teachers, it may be 80. So whoever teachers you take the class, that doesn't matter for me for the time being. But whatever time they will allot, you have to figure out that I have to complete it in 4 months. All right. So if you see together, you have 23 months, but I have given you 2 years stretch over here. See, this one month buffer I have intentionally planned for you, again to keep you relaxed, to give you an opportunity to revise what you have studied in previous, you can say, full year. So if you have studied for 11 months, take 1 month break and then start for next. Or you study for 12 months, take 1 month break, then you start for next. So break it like that. All right, this 1 month buffer is very much required to balance you, so that you, even if you have missed something, you can make it up. Okay, so it brings you back on the track. Maybe your personal works have got delayed, you can make it up in this 1 month. This 1 month buffer can be planned and used as per your choice. If there is any backlog, you can complete. If there is any revision, if you want to do that, you can do. If there is any extra classes headed in your previous subjects, then that should be utilized for the purpose. All right. So fifth is your time required. Next is your sequence of tuition. Next is your sequence of tuition. This is not fifth, this is fourth. Next is your sequence of tuitions. See, for sequence, many students plan only one group at a time. But right now in this session, I am not going to give you any suggestion for one group at a time. I'm going to give you suggestion for both groups. If you are giving for both groups, then how should you plan the sequence? See, I will break this into year 1 and year 2. Okay. In year 1, the first tuition I am advising to take is SFM, CFR, that is your corporate financial reporting accounts, and then SCM. Prefer in this sequence 1, 2, 3. Prefer. Usually students were doing SCM, SFM, CFR. Yeah, this is also good. This is also good. But I am changing for my subject specially this time, because you know SCM is one of the most revamped subject of your CA final new syllabus, because the questions that institute are asking in SCM are something usually which are not even there in institute material. Yes. So they've started this trend in most of the subjects, but in SCM it's very, very dynamically done now. So students who are taking classes in initial days of their CA final timeline for SCM, they need to do now lot of extra questions, which again demands another some 20-30 classes sometimes, and that becomes very painful. And frankly, I don't know that whether institute has, although latest institute material has come in this May 21, but I don't know that whether institute has actually stopped making new questions or not. And the institute will never stop. So they keep making new questions, they keep adding new questions. So since SCM is now more case study oriented, not very practical like SFM and CFR, less practical than SFM and CFR. Case study oriented means it is also incorporating several theoretical concepts. So it is creating challenge for students now to remember SCM until that time, until the time of examination. So I am intentionally suggesting that it is preferred that you take SFM first, CFR second, and SCM third. And by the way, even if you are taking this sequence, I don't have any issues. It's just that you have to give extra effort to again revise SCM, maybe in that 1 month buffer period, so that you are all up to date after 1 year. Say you have started with first tuition as SCM, then you will get some gap, as I shared with you, 1 month buffer will be there in between. So after a year, you up to date yourself. So that is very much required. And even if you don't, then towards the end of your preparation, that is in the last 6 months, you will have to allocate some extra time to SCM in order to cover up all the new questions that have come post your batch completion. Although keeping this trend in mind that SCM is taken as first tuition by the students, we in SGC has started this from this 2021 onwards, that we are giving a validity of 2.5 years to the students, so that they don't have to worry about revision of the classes towards the end. So this is something new which we have brought, and I think no other teacher is currently giving you this long benefit in any subject. But in SCM, we thought for you and we started this already with our registered students of January onwards. Alright. So even for old students, we'll be working on it, we'll be trying to give them some extension. But since the software doesn't permit to give it to old students, we have been working with software developers to get that solution. But right now, dear old students who have already taken the classes, please cooperate with us. As soon as any solution will come, we will intimate you directly. For SCM, old students, alright. So old students means those who have already taken the classes with lesser validity. So usually we charge extra for increasing the validity. And I understand that by listening to this, you might feel a little uncomfortable that you have paid charges to us and you have got less validity. Why others are getting high validity? See, this development we keep doing for our students, and those who have got something less, we will try to make it up for you. We are already in talking terms with our software providers, and once any solution comes, we will update you. Alright. And this we are doing only for the students who are doing our classes in content browser software, and the students who are doing classes in concept software, there is no possibility of extending your classes for 2.5 years. So there the software limitation is only that way. But for content browser, we are trying to work with our software developer. Anyways, in year two, you have to take remaining tuitions, and that sequence will be, the sequence there will be law first, audit second, DT next, then elective, and then IDT. So this is the sequence, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Alright. So for accounts is 4 months, for SFM is 3 months, and for SCM is 4 months. So 4, 3, 7 or 11, I'm sorry. So this is your 11 months and this is your 12 months. So study for 11 months, take 1 month recess or 1 month buffer time, and then study for next 12 months. Alright, so 4, 3, 7 and 4, 11 is the first year, and rest 2, 4, 2, 6, 4, 10 into 12 is your सेकेंड ईयर. सो दिस प्लानिंग इज मोस्ट एप्ट फॉर स्टूडेंट्स लाइक यू. एंड इफ यू आर एनी हाउ प्लानिंग टू गिव ओनली ग्रुप वन एंड ग्रुप टू, देन दिस नीड्स टू बी चेंज. एंड फॉर दैट यू हैव टू डिस्कस पर्सनली फॉर दैट. ऑल राइट, आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी मच ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड नाउ. इफ यू आर वॉचिंग विद पेरेंट्स, then there is another concern that sir, how much would be the investment in giving my child to CA final. So usually the investment is around, say for accounts the fees is around 18,000 to 20,000, here it is around 18,000. Then for law I'm just taking tentative 10 or maybe sometimes 12 also, but I'm just taking a tentative figure. So 38, 10, 48, 10, 58, and then for SCM it is 15, elective it is 7,000, 8,000, DT it is 15, IDT is 14. So it is 15, 8, 23, 37, and 15 is 52. So tentatively it is around 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so sometimes if students are comfortable in doing some subject themselves, so they may save some money, but this is a tentative estimate of 1 lakh rupees to do all the subjects tuition. All right, so I hope this idea is clear. Next, you must be waiting for, should I join some other courses? So this is one very common question among the students. Should I join some other courses because I just don't want to be a CA? See, what I say, once a CA, always a CA, and only CA is enough to give you all your dreams. Yeah, it's a fact. If you're just a CA, you can achieve all your dreams. But still, if you have fascination, if you are some, you know, desire, dreams, if you want to show off in a positive note, if you really had some desire and dreams to be accomplished, then you may. Then options are, you can do cost accountant degree, you can do CS, you can do CFA, you can do CIMA, you can do USCMA, you can do ACCA. Alright, these four are professional degrees. Some prefer doing FRM, some prefer MBA. Alright, so there are a lot of options, and frankly speaking, for picking up anything, it will consume another set of time and effort. And we have seen students getting disbalanced. My suggestion is, if you have to do, you prefer doing it post your appearing of CA final. So that time you will be able to focus on this. Then your articleship will convert into job, and then you don't have any other thing to do. So continue studies for another 2 years or 3 years and take up some extra qualifications. So that way you will be able to devote yourself completely to any kind of study. That is my suggestion. But anyhow, if you have to discuss about this personally, then personally you have to come. Otherwise, I am not sharing this right now in this open platform. For sure short success, sir, what I need to do? For sure short success, there is only one single word you will be shocked to hear, but that's only the fact. The only thing that you need is consistency. Consistency in your execution. A simple plan that I have given you for this first year and second year, and then break up of the same, if you just follow that consistently, and if you are able to save that 6 months before your exam in hand, it will be a sure shot success. There is another set of study plan which is needed for last 6 months. Study plan is there for last 6 months, which is not the agenda of this video, but in short, one word that gives you sure shot success is consistency in execution. So if it means that in year one you have to complete this three, you have to. If in year two you have to complete that five subjects, you have to. Either you are doing it by tuition, or you can do it definitely by yourself also, by referring to notes or institute material as well. So you can refer any. It's not that you have to have take tuitions for all the subjects. Wherever you feel that in intermediate you were lacking on some subjects, you join that tuition only. But it's tuition gives you discipline to study for sure. In self-study, we usually deviate, we procrastinate. So that happens, that is a fact also. So whatever way you go, be it self-study or through the help of tuition classes, the point is consistency. Consistency means year one, I have to complete first three, and year two, I have to complete rest five. Whatever come on my way in my life, I will achieve these milestones for sure. I'll save 6 months, and that 6 months has got a different strategy altogether. So to sum up, I shared with you what? I shared with you articleship training is required for 2.5 years before the final exam. Ideally, it is 3 years. Articleship is of 3 years, but last 6 months is done after giving the final exam. And in that, I have divided it into 6 months of self-study, 2 months of tuition with 1 month buffer. All right. And you have to also prepare your mind for balancing of work with study. Mode of tuition, pre-pandemic classes at home was there, face-to-face was there. But now face-to-face has converted into live classes at home, and classes at home, GDPD is also there. So I just helped you to understand the difference, and you can choose any as per your convenience, but try to be within your time frame. Number of subjects are 8, group 1, 4, group 2, 4. Time required I shared with you. Total 23 months timeline is there. Cost total 1 lakh is there approximately. Total approximately 515 or 520 classes, which is approximately 1650 hours of coaching classes. And usually during your final period, you either have college, or then articleship, then tuition. So this is the sequence that we follow. And if you don't have college, keep that time surplus for revision. Don't start unnecessarily two tuitions if you are following this basic time guideline. If anyhow you have started late, then I feel that that timeline needs to be prepared as per your current situation. So for that only we have started with our self-study mentoring, so that we can continuously guide you as per your requirements. Then sequence I have suggested that usually students take SFM, CFR, SCM, and usually students take SCM, SFM, CFR, but this time I am suggesting that you take SFM first, then CFR, then SCM. Why SCM is third? Because every term institute is bringing new questions. Each term they bring three set of papers. One is RTP, then is MTP, then it is the exam paper. So in these three terms, in these three papers in each term, they keep adding some questions. So if you are taking classes 2 years earlier or the first tuition, then just imagine at least I will say 9 to 10 papers you have to solve before your final exam. At least three terms paper will have to be covered up. Each term three papers are there. So that is quite lengthy, right? So that's why I'm advising that why not take this as third tuition. You may think over it again, and if say again you feel that you have to take it as first tuition, I don't have any problem. We have extended validity for you so that you don't have to suffer. Should I join some other courses? I always say do anything after CA, because CA in itself is very challenging, very demanding. So invite anything other than CA, if you are taking the load, it's like, you know, aa bell mujhe maar wala concept. That means you are inviting a bull to hit you. It is something like that. And like CA, if you enter into anything, you will have to devote time for that also. These all courses are also very demanding. But still, if you have dreams to do, you have potential, you want to work very, very hard, then it has to be customized guidance for you. It can't be universally said on this video. For sure shot success, just one mantra: consistency. Consistency is what? Study plan for last 6 months has to be followed, and along with this, study plan for the first 2 years has to be followed. For first 2 years, as regard last 6 months, it goes in a different intensity at all. So for that, we have a different program so that you can inquire for and understand. Thank you all. This was this much only this video. I hope you enjoyed the content, and I just hope that more than enjoyment, it was value adding. So keep a note of everything that I've shared and paste it somewhere, that this is my timeline for another 2 years and 3 years, and follow that continuously. I am sure that you all will pass in one attempt only, or one attempt means the first attempt itself. Thank you. All the best. Bye bye.